I'm Ashwarya Singh from St. James Kindergarten Garden, and I'm here to teach you SST for class 5. In previous video, we have discussed about the planet, the Earth, or planet, and about the globe, maps, planets, and meridians. In this chapter, we are going to read about the movements of the Earth. As you know, during the earlier times, people believed that Earth is a flat surface. And people also believe that the Earth is a stationary object. It is a stationary object. It doesn't move around, and the other heavenly bodies move around the Earth. But a Polish astronomer named Nicolaus Copernicus. This astronomer proved that Earth is not a stationary object, but it has two types of movements. As it moves around the sun, sun is a stationary object, and it moves around the sun, and also it spins on its own axis. I have a globe. Look at here. This is a model of Earth that is known as globe. And Nicolaus Copernicus proved that Earth is spin on its own axis. This is axis. Axis is an imaginary line on which the Earth rotates. Earth rotates on its own axis, as well as it also revolves around the sun. Sun is in the center and it revolves around the sun. Thus, we have two kinds of movements in our Earth. One is rotation and second is revolution. Two types of movement. Note it down in your notebook. Two types of movements that the Earth has of movement of the Earth are, first is rotation and second is revolution. We will discuss it one by one. First of all, come to the rotation. Rotation is the movement of the Earth on its own axis. Rotation is the movement of the Earth on its own axis. This is Earth, and when it revolves on its own axis, when it revolves around on its own axis, this movement of the Earth is known as rotation. Okay, you can see it spins at its own axis. This kind of movement of the Earth is known as rotation. You can write the definition. The movement of the Earth, the movement of the Earth on its own axis is known as rotation. This is the definition. This is known as rotation. Yes. Now move to the next. Now the second question is, how much time it takes to rotate in its own axis? One complete rotation. The Earth take how much time to rotate fully on its own axis? Suppose that you can see over here, suppose that this portion. Now in front of you, the Asia is here. Now it started to rotate on its own axis. It is rotating, and again it comes on the same place. Means it takes how much time to complete one rotation? The Earth takes 1 day. 1 day, you know how much hours 1 day? 1 day has 24 hours. So it means one rotation is equal to 1 day. One rotation is equal to 1 day, or you may say 24 hours. We can say Earth takes 24 hours or 1 day to complete one rotation. It takes 1 day to complete one rotation on its axis. Okay? And what is the direction of movement right to left or left? Generally, Earth rotates from west to east. Suppose that this is west and this is east. If we suppose this direction is west and this direction is east, then it moves like this. See, the rotation is from west to east. You can write also rotation of Earth is from west to east. What is the direction of rotation? West to east. It means it move from west to east. That's why we see the sun is moving from east to west. It seems to us from the earth that earth rises in the east and sets in the west. Why is it so? Because of the rotation of the earth. As the earth moves west to east, it seems from earth, sun is rises in the east and sets in the west. This is the main reason behind that. Now come to the next. Rotation also cause one important thing. What important thing? Days and nights. Have you ever think how days and night occur? Yes, it is because of rotation only. How? We will see. How the rotation causes the days and night? The next topic is days and night. Days and night. How the rotation causes days and night? We will see. The rotation of the days, the rotation of the earth causes days and nights. Due to its spherical shape. The earth's shape is spherical. You can see this, it's like a sphere. Only half of the earth. Suppose you can see, I am showing you through analogy. Suppose this is sun. You can this torch is, you can assume this is sun and this is earth. At one time, what happened? Only half of the earth received the light. You can see over here, only half portion can receive the light. Why? Because of its spherical shape. If it is flat, then it receives total light of the sun. But because this is spherical in shape, only half of the portion, this portion, only half portion receives sunlight and other half does not. That's why the part of the earth that receives the sunlight, look at it, the part of the earth that receives the sunlight means half of the earth. This part has day. This part has day and the part which does not receive the light has darkness, and that's why this portion has night. You see the rotation of, suppose that this portion, this Asia, receive light from the sun. This is sun, okay, and this is receiving. Means in Asia it has night, it has day, sorry, it has day because it received the sunlight. This portion received the sunlight, this portion has day. It means this has day. And the portion which is in the opposite, which portion is in the opposite? The America, North America and South America. This portion is in darkness, this portion does not receive the light of the sun. It means this portion has night in its part. Okay, understood? You can see through an activity also. Once again, I am showing you. Yes. Again, this portion, look at here. You can see. I can show you through this also. Wait. Yes. This portion has now, this time, it has daytime. Now it is starting to rotate. You can see it is slowly moving on its axis. As you know, two kinds of rotation the earth have. Now it's starting to spin. Spinning at it. See the portion which is in the daytime, now it's the daytime in the America, North America and South America, it's daytime. And this portion Asia has nighttime. Now it is starting to spin slowly from west, as you know, the direction of the movement from west to east. Now it is moving, started moving slowly, and the rotation takes 1 day, 24 hours. Started, you can see it is started rotating. Now it's the portion which was in the dark, the Asia country, now it's moving towards the sun, and the portion which is in front of sun is moving towards the dark sea. And after 12 hours, after 24 hours, completely see. After 12 hours, this portion, now it's come in darkness. There is no light over here, and this portion night time. Now you understood how the days and nights pass because of the rotation of the earth. Suppose there was no movement in the earth. Suppose there is no movement in the earth. Does days and nights pass? No, it is not. Suppose this is, if it is standing, if it is stationary, this earth. Now with this motion completely have day and this portion completely in dark. Why? It is not rotating. This continuously this portion getting light, and because of getting light it has day all the time, and because this portion does not get any light, it is in the darkness, the completely it is darkness, so it, this portion has night. So it is not possible without the rotation. So we can say rotation causes days and night. Thank you, children.